The second chapter of history, Reformation. So, after the fall of Roman Empire, the Roman Catholic Church remained the most powerful institution in Europe, and all of Western Europe's Christians were Catholic. That was a period when Church used to dominate the political, economical, and social structure of the society. And the influence of the Church and its questionable practices resulted in division of thoughts toward this religion. And it demanded a reform, it demanded a change. This movement of change in the power and beliefs established a new way of structuring the society and beliefs towards religion and defined the continent in an era of reformation. This reformation toward religious outlook was due to corrupt church practices, and during the Renaissance, many authors and intellectuals condemned the church practices. It gave to rise of a new way towards Christianity, that is human Christianity, Christian humanism, which criticized the cruel practice of the church. That was also the time when the church, the Catholic Church, was authoritarian in nature. They used to control the kingdom through the kings and dominate the social order of that age. During that period, church used to be wealthy, powerful, and discriminatory. During that period, the church also used to collect taxes called tithes. And people were opposed to this as it was a financial burden for them. It also interfered in the matters of the state frequently and considered itself as the supreme and the ultimate authority in both spiritual and the matters related with administration of a kingdom. These practices caused resentment among the people, although very few dared to question the authority of the church. The main reason that impacted the people during that period for a change, for a reform, was the sale of indulgence. Indulgences means forgiveness before God for the punishment one has done due to sinful activities. And in 1517, Pope's representative visited Germany to auction this indulgence letter of pardon, because Pope needed money to meet his extravagant expenses. This event set the Reformation movement in a full swing.